only the physical side, we also have the moral side. Look at this generation nowadays. We don't know what's right, we don't know what's wrong. The wrong is made right, and the right is made wrong. I'm based in Mandaluyong. It's usually, it's probably a depressed area. You go around, you see somebody killed by EGK, and what will they say? Father, good for him, he's really not focused. We have lost, in other words, our moral compass. That's why how beautiful the gospel is today. Go to all the ends of the earth. The harvest is great, but the laborers are few. And my dear friends, in the gospel today, he also tells his disciples, 70 of them, something very interesting. No money bag, no sackcloth, no sandals. And Jesus tells them this reality for three reasons. First of all, no money bags, no sackcloths, no sandals, because he wants his disciples to trust God. Jesus once told his disciples, in this world we cannot have two masters. We're going to love one, we're going to despise the other. For the Jews, that was something very interesting, because we know that when it comes to money, the Jews are one of the best. When it comes to money, the Jews think that one who is rich is truly blessed. But here is God saying, in this life we cannot have two masters. We're going to love one, we're going to despise the other. A true disciple is one who trusts God and not the material things. Second, Jesus says, carry no money bag, no sack, no sandals, no sack. Why? Because Jesus would like to inform and tell his disciples, God always provides. I come from a seminary which is for lay vocation, 25 to 40 years old, and many of the applicants are the breadwinners of the family. And surely it's very hard reality, letting go of the opportunity to help the family to enter the priesthood. But ask all of those who became priests. They will always say, in God's mysterious ways, in God's mysterious time, he always provides. When Jesus says, don't bring any material things, it's only because God will always provide. And third, no material things, because God wants us to be flexible. We all know this, the heavier the material things, the harder it is to move from one place to another. Hence, the gospel is compromise. And in life, not only material things slow us down. It's the emotional baggage, the anger, the unforgiveness, the hurt. We always look back, we never move forward. That's why this month, my dear friends, as we continue the journey, in all the people that we encounter, not only in this group, but everywhere, we pray that we may become laborers in the harvest of the Lord. And this can only become a reality in three things. If we trust God, if we know His provision, and yes, if we travel light. 60 kilos only. For economy, 60 pounds for economy. 80 pounds for